Okay, so welcome back. This is going to be just a super quick, easy tutorial. I actually watched it over at Jamie Fenn's channel, so I think a lot of you guys already saw it. But one thing I struggle with is how will it look on the cell phone when I export it out? Because sometimes there's a slight color shift, you know, an iPhone looks in a certain way. So, you know, usually when I do edits, I export it, I airdrop it to my phone just to see, okay, does this look good or does it look not good? And then if it doesn't look good, you need to do it all again. So with the new DaVinci 18.5 update with Blackmagic Cloud, you can actually remote monitor on your phone in real time. So you can also do this for your clients. It's free. It doesn't cost anything. Or you can do it for yourself, like I do in this case. So I'm going to screen share my phone and I'm going to screen share from my computer so we can see how this will look. So let's just dive into it, okay? Okay, yeah. So as you can see here now on the screen, I've got this this clip from when I was doing a vlog earlier. It looks fairly nice. It looks like I wanted it to do. Yeah, that's no worries. But if I would like to see how this would look on my phone, what I now can do is I can go up to Workspace, scroll down to Remote Monitoring, and here I can choose how to monitor it. I want to monitor it in 420 10-bit. I want it to be 20 megabits per second. And then you start the session. But before you do this, the person that has the that wants to remote view this needs to go into Blackmagic Cloud like this. So here you have it. Then if you don't have an account, you just sign up. And if you have an account, you sign in, like I already have my account. Okay, yeah. So here's my account. And then I just push login. Doesn't really matter. But here you see you have everything that you need from Blackmagic Cloud. And then once you, like I said here, activated, then you have remote session down here. So what we need to do now, so in order for us to get this to work, we need to go to App Store in our phone. We need to search for DaVinci Remote Monitor. And the app looks like this. And you download it. And then you open it up. And here you can see I'm already logged in, but otherwise it's going to look just like it did online. And here you see, join remote monitor session, and then you have the session code. So then we go back to the DaVinci on the computer. We press start session, and then we get this long number. You can just copy it. And as you all know, if you're on iPhone, you can just copy it in your Mac, and then just paste it in here, done, and then join. And there we go. So now, press play. And you have it in real time. You can see exactly how it looks. I think this is a super amazing tool. And it's so very helpful. And then if you pause it, yeah. And then when you're done, obviously, you just end session. So to sum this up, this tool is super easy to use. It's super good if you want to remote monitor stuff on a phone or on an iPad, or if you just want to show your clients that might not be available to see it on the spot and you don't want to go, you know, export, send, because this way you can actually be in direct contact with your customer or with your friend or whoever you're grading with or just editing with. It's super easy. There's basically zero lag and it makes my life so much easier. I've left a link in the description so you can go into Blackmagic Cloud and sign up. I don't know why, but I had some issues finding it myself, so I'm just making your life easier. And yeah, I mean, then it's just, you know, log on, download the app, and try it, and just, you know, be amazed, because I was so happy when I found this. It's a super easy hack, but it makes your life so much easier. Also for vertical content, how it will look. And yeah, there's multiple, you know, different ways of using this. So anyway, that was it for today. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. That's the first time I say it. Like and subscribe. And I will drop some more videos soon. I'm going to France this weekend with the family. So hopefully I'll find some nice places to shoot down there, because I'm still in need to do the comparison of the two anamorphic adapters I have. But that's a story for another time. And yeah, for now, just, you know, Jenna, hush, hey.